Joel. Joel. The phone is ringing.
Well, what'd you expect it to do? Sing?
Maybe it's important.
Probably.
Maybe the building is on fire.
No.
I do all the work around here while you lying alone. It's Christopher Oates. He's babbling incoherently about something. How do you feel?
Oh, I feel wonderful, I think. What did we have to eat last night? Fried carpets?
Oh, I feel as if I swallowed a jam session, jitterbugs and all.
Careful and don't trip. The mailman probably left a giant stack of orders for us to fill.
It's not that business is so bad, it's just that our budget is usually miles ahead of it. Every time we make a sale, we throw a party.
Yes, darling, it's true, I did get shot once. But that was when my back was turned.
Mm. Your back was turned, all right. Look at these air-conditioned breeches.
Well, it didn't amount to much. It was only a flesh wound.
It was only a flesh wound, all right. You certainly looked undignified sitting around in this thing for 6 weeks.
Now, look here.
Are we seeing Rafferty?
What's good about it?
Why am I? You're cheerful.
Hey, what are you doing?
Look at that.
Why, you shouldn't
Will you go, will you, Scram?
I wouldn't do that if I were you. You're wasting an awful lot of energy.
Besides, now, listen, Double Ugly, please.
But you don't understand.
Wait a minute, Polka Dot. I am a reporter. I write little things for the paper, and I've got a story. I just dug it out with my own teeth. So if you'll just...
You may have a story, but you ain't got no paper to publish it in, Fletch.
Hey!
I got a good panel for sale. Somebody...
You're Mr. Buckley.
I beg your pardon?
Oh.
What?
Oh, I expected something old and soft. You're the callow, wet behind the ears type.
Preston!
Don't you dare try to get me thrown out of here.
I just want my pants. Preston, I want my
trousers.
Here, give me those.
Yes, I wish you would maybe go with my professional.
You may go, Preston.
Yes, sir.
Here, hold these.
I've been embarrassed.
Oh, dear, that's the wrong end.
Anything
down.
Oh.
I'm so sorry. Here. Mr. Buckley, I don't wear pants.
No?
As though if you were only a newspaper man.
But I'm not.
And you never were. You don't know what it is to be brought up in a city room, to teeth on linotype slugs, feed on printer's ink.
Sounds rather unsanitary. Would you mind turning around? Oh, you know everything, don't you?
Well, that's what you pay me for. Oh, Mr. Buckley, please.
Huh?
You may be a social lion to your friends, but to me, you're just an animal cracker.
Wonder who she was.
According to me, she's saying... She said, if we get married, we spoil our beautiful friendship.
Senor Don Jose Antonio Francisco de Fragosa de Fraganza, you are a liar. You said that to her.
You said that to me 4 years ago.
You're the sort of man who was born with a flower in his buttonhole. But when Stephen Dexter shows up in a flower, spring is here. And he's about to break out again. And when he starts to hum, Anita, Juanita, yada, yada, yada. He's gone. He's a sick man.
I still do not like him. The big stiff, how dare he hum at the blonde when he can hum at you?
Oh, well, he did Juanita me a little bit the first spring I worked for him. But I put him in his place.
Uh-huh. A good opening move.
No. No, bad. He stayed there.
Hello, Beatrice. How's advice to the lovelorn?
Fine. My cat just had kittens again. Their own fault.
Yeah. Would you mind if I sat down?
There's been a lamp burning in the window for you, honey. Here.
Oh, I jumped out that window a long time ago, Walter.
How long is it?
How long is what?
You know what. How long is it since we've seen each other?
Oh, well, let's see. I spent 6 weeks in Reno, then Bermuda. About 4 months, I guess. Seems like yesterday to me.
Maybe it was yesterday, Hildy. Been seeing me in your dreams?
No, Mama doesn't dream about you anymore, Wally. You wouldn't know the old girl now.
Yes, I would. I'd know you anytime,
any
place.
Anywhere. Ah, you're repeating yourself, Walter. That's the speech you made the night you proposed.
Yeah, I know this. You still remember it.
Of course I remember it. If I didn't remember it, I wouldn't have divorced you.
Sorry, miss. You can't ride in this. This is for baggage only.
Pretend I'm a trunk. Take me down.
Where to, miss?
Steerage, please.
Okay.
What's the matter with you?
I'm all right.
Nearly had a nasty accident.
Nearly?
Yeah. Smeared it a little bit.
Ooh.
I can fix that, all right.
You what?
I say you smeared it when you rolled in it.
You realize I might have broken my neck?
No, you couldn't have broken your neck the way you fell. You might have broken your arm. That would have mended in time. Run along. I've wasted enough time on you.
My uncle happens to own this meadow.
Will you get back to that hunting set of which you seem to be a peculiarly incompetent member?
Everybody takes a spill now and then.
Yes, I know that. Shoot, go on. Don't they look where they're going? Hey, you forgot your fishing rod. Hey, what's the matter? Hey, what's the matter? Hey, say something.
Not since the debut of the...
Debut,
okay. Not since the debut of the great Sarah Bernhardt has an audience been held so spellbound as that which witnessed a remarkable performance of Ibsen's A Doll's House by a young Columbus girl, Eileen Sherwood. Huh. Sure pouring it on, ain't you? When did this happen?
It's happening tonight at 8:30.
What? Hey, something new. Now they're writing them before they see them.
Won't have time to write it after the show. We're having a party tonight at the house for Eileen.
A party? With the doll?
Will you scram?
Eileen's
review is already written. It's
ready,
in the
everybody?
Paper now.
Please!
That paper will be on the streets
lights.
In an hour. Says she's sensational in the doll
curtain,
house.
Curtain.
Your picture's in the bed.
Hide the Christmas tree carefully. Hello?
Well, then, you little...
What would it be, folks?
Aspirin. Bicarbonate.
Promo.
Excuse me.
Now, wait a minute. This is for McGregor, personally.
I'm McGregor, personally. Come in. It was my ex-husband who committed them.
Ho, ho!
If Marconi here weren't leering at me, I'd tell you I love you. Wait a minute.
I love you.
We've got to reach a decision. Now
don't
I think...
Don't bother your pretty little head about it. Monica, angel, how are you? How sweet of you to call me and you so busy. Did I tell you I saw your last picture?
Emily Goes to Town.
Emily Goes to Town. Oh, simply wonderful. Now, what seems to be the trouble? Oh, but there's no such thing, Angel, as a small part. Just small actresses. What? Oh, you get killed in the first reel. Oh, but darling, think how they're going to miss you throughout the rest of the picture. Oh, now, Angel, you haven't a thing to worry about. How's the new pool? You like it? You like water in it? Then you go back and finish your sunbath, darling. Goodbye, Angel.
Not a single arrest today, Mother.
Don't get discouraged. I'm sure you'll do better next time.
You're great, Sister George.
What do you mean, Sister George? That's St. George the Dragon Killer.
Did you hear that, Mother?
I did. And you're looking at one dragon St. George isn't going to kill.